One of the most common questions I get from youth and high school baseball players and their parents is, how do I get, or how do I get my son throwing harder and doing so safely? Like anything, there is no one answer, no one quick fix to this question. If there is someone that tells you, hey, you need to do this one thing, this quick change, this one thing, and it's going to drastically make you start throwing 3, 4, 5+ miles an hour more, you got to be careful with that because it's likely coming at the increase of an increased risk of a serious arm injury, such as some type of labrum tear, UCL sprain, UCL injury. So when we're looking at that question, we want to take an approach that looks at the entire athlete's potential as a whole. And in general, the framework that we follow is these couple things here. We want to work on increasing arm strength and endurance, specifically the rotator cuff. When we look at the rotator cuff, those are the brakes on the back of the shoulder, but also what actively pulls our arm into external rotation. And then the other side of it on the front is more of the gas, the accelerator. So pec, lat, subscap, those are the specific areas we want to train. And then in terms of increasing general arm strength, that comes from upper body lifting more than anything. The next thing we want to focus on is increasing lower body strength. If you only pitch and throw with your arm, you are going to get hurt. Pitching and throwing is a full body movement. You generate force from the ground, you push off the mound, push off the ground, you transfer that force through the rest of your lower body, up through your core, up to the arm, and up to the ball to generate maximum throwing velocity. So, being that we generate all of our force and power from our lower body, we want to make sure we train our lower body. A stronger lower body is a lower body that is able to generate more force. The ability to generate more force will ultimately lead to greater throwing velocity. The next side of that, it's improving hip and spine mobility, specifically of the thoracic spine. Those are two key areas and areas that need to move properly for throwing. If you are stiff and limited in your hip and thoracic spine, you will not be able to get into positions that you need to optimize your throwing mechanics. Bad throwing mechanics, injury will eventually lead to some type of injury risk and really just hindered performance, not being able to throw as hard. The next thing on there is core strength and endurance. When I mean core, I'm really just talking about the trunk more than anything. I don't like to look at the trunk as a force generator. It's more of a force transfer. And what do I mean by that is you want to create all your power and force from your lower body. And the goal of your core is to hold and then create certain positions to transfer that force. It's usually more of the holding positions more than anything. If you get tired in your core quickly, you then start to lose power and leak energy. And if you keep trying to throw hard and you can't get all that power from your core to your body, from your lower body to your upper body, because you're losing it through your core, it leads to you putting more stress on your arm to maintain that throwing velocity. And the last thing I always stress to guys is you want to work with a qualified pitching coach. I am not a pitching coach. I'm a doctor of physical therapy and an athletic trainer. I know the positions that pitchers and baseball players need to be put in for throwing with safe, essentially with safe mechanic or safe positions more than anything, the ability to get into those positions safely and be stable in those positions. And then it's the job of that pitching coach to work on to work on tinkering with those positions to make sure that they're optimizing their mechanics best. So that's something we always stress to guys is making sure that you're working with a qualified pitching coach that not only prioritizes your performance, but prioritizes your overall arm health and career longevity. So that's really the way that we approach that question of how can I or how can I get my son to throw harder safely? Again, there's no one size fits all approach to this. It has to be tailored individually to each player. So, if you're a baseball player, especially a pitcher, and you found this content helpful, go ahead and like and subscribe our channel. Leave a comment below with any questions you have, or check out any of our free resources we have dedicated to baseball players and throwing athletes.